this is Rochelle Corbio, and I am Miss Maxim Canada 2008, and you're watching MMA Crossfire. Stay tuned.
What's it like for a young fighter who's trying to work his way up to a spot like George to be sort of with him along the journey and to see how he handles himself and see how he does the media and all that? And just to, I mean, do you try to follow in his footsteps and use what he does as a sort of example of what you want to be?
Definitely. I mean, being in the present, it's a privilege to be able to sit next to a great friend and a mentor for me. Being able to be in a position to be from the same camp and train with him, and seeing him go from great, you know, he started as a great fighter. Now he's one of the greatest fighters in the world, and it's an honor for me to be able to look at him achieve everything that he's achieved and to follow on that footstep.
And you had a tough fight against Mark Hominick 6 or 8 months or so ago. Now he's fighting for the title. When you look at him in that spot, does a part of you think what might have been, you were so close, if you had defeated him and maybe one more win, you could have been in that title hunt?
I'm the kind of person that thinks that everything happens for a reason in life, and I think how many times is right now, and my time is definitely to come.
For George, you seem to be really relaxed and stuff. Tell us about how much you're enjoying this week. And also, as we are only 2 days away prior to your big fight, you know, the pressure that you feel, is it mounting? Do you enjoy it? And also, do you have any idea how you're going to feel standing inside that octagon in front of 55,000 people and Bruce Buffer introduces you?
Well, it's a very stressful job that I do, you know, because if you think about it, all the work that we put into this happened in less than 25, like in 25 minutes, you know. All the work that I've done, it's gonna be a 25 minute, you know. So in this 25 minute, it's gonna be the result of all my work. So it's very stressful. So to make things more easy, you know, to make more fun, I need to joke around, to have great friend with me, a great entourage, you know. I'm laughing all day, and you know, for me, yeah, I'm relaxed all the time. I'm focused, so I'll be I'm nervous, of course, but it's not time to be stressed right now. It's not time to be stiff. You know, it's gonna be time for business when I step into the octagon. But before that, I need to relax. You know, it's better for my body to not be stressed all the time. And with the experience, you learn how to deal with this.
George, Jake over here.
Oh, sorry.
Jake was saying earlier that he's actually been a little overwhelmed with the media obligations that he's had to face this weekend. Do you feel the same, or are you used to this, or did you expect all of this, or has it been what you expected?
Well, it's different all the time. Every UFC is different. UFC 100 was huge too. This is huge also because it's the first time in Ontario with 55,000 fans. And of course, the guy that I'm fighting, I consider him like the best guy that I've fought in my career, you know. The bar has been raised very, very high for this fight. And it's going to be big. It's the biggest fight of my career. And I want to be the one that beat Jake Shield, you know, the great Jake Shield. Something that it not have been done for, you know, for 6 years. And, you know, it's the pressure is there, and, you know, I'm at my best when it's like that. You know, when I'm against the edge, that's when I perform the best. And it's in terms of if it's going to play on the fight or not, I don't think so. I don't think it really matter. You know, it's when the door will close, everything will play there, you know.
George, I know that one of your jobs some years ago was you worked a door at a nightclub. Did you ever have to do what you did in the cage? Did you have to disarm people?
Not disarm, but I was where I used to work back then. It was pretty bad. It was called Fuzzy Brassard. It was a hip hop club, and people know that hip hop crowd, you know, are normally known for violence. You know, it's because the lyrics of in hip hop and everything. You know, it's they have the mentality that it's cool to be a gangster. You know, so I was working in that environment. Plus, you know, I'm about 190 pounds, you know. Most of the guys that was working with me, they were like 220, 225, and even more than that. So I was pretty small. And the thing is, I was fortunate enough to, most of the time, to talk my way out of trouble. So when I had problem with someone, I was able to talk. I was not using my strength. I think it's the best way in the street, in general, to deal with problem, you know. You can be strong as much as you want, but nobody is faster than a bullet. And I remember when I stopped working there, someone got shot like 2 weeks after I stopped working. I was like, God, thanks, I stopped doing this. You know, it was a tough time, but I didn't have choice at the time. But you know, it's always better to talk than use violence. It's always better doing it like this.
And you like French hip hop, and will you come out to? Can you tell us what song you're going to come out to?
Yeah, I might come out on. I use always a song that inspires in the moment, and I'll come out on a song. It's called "Ne compare pas." It's by Youssoufa and Arsenic. It's a good song. I like it.
For use, please. Can you go back to your last fight? I mean, you debuted in the WC. You have two great fights, but you come up short both times. What's the emotion like going to that last fight? And how important was that victory for you?
It was a very important fight for me because knowing the merge between the WC and UFC, I knew that if I was going to make the transition there, I would have to score a win. So that was my motivation in training and preparation for this fight. I really had to kick it up a notch and really go out there and show all my skills and to get a victory.
And every fighter on this card has been asked what it's going to be like fighting in front of 55,000 people and what's the pressure like and all that. But your last fight was at the Palms, which is the smallest venue the UFC holds events at, and now you're the biggest one in history. Maybe it's not pressure, but how do you compare and contrast those experiences?
Well, in the end, it's the same thing. You know, there's one purpose, is going to the cage once the door is shot is one-on-one. I mean, the crowd and everything is just a background noise. So basically, all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have a tunnel vision to get to the cage and get to the fight.
Guys, we're going to take this one and then one more after this, okay? So, for George, you say that this is the toughest challenge of your career, and you feel like Jake Shields is raising the bar. He wasn't able to finish Martin Kampmann. He had struggling with Jason Miller. What is it that, and he's been, a lot of fans aren't really seeing him as that big of an opponent to you. What do you see in Jake Shields that a lot of fans don't?
You know, people don't realize that someone who's good with submission, like leg lock or armbar or choke, someone who's very good. And you know, there is black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and there is black belt level like Jake Shield is. He's a champion level black belt. He can finish black belt. And people doesn't acknowledge his skills, how good he is, because they don't realize that if you're really good with submission, it's just as dangerous as a knockout puncher. For instance, you can win the whole fight, and I'm in the fifth round, I'm winning the fifth round, and I commit a mistake. I get caught in an arm bar. I have to tap, otherwise my arm will snap, or I'm gonna get choked out. It's just as dangerous as a knockout punch. People, they don't acknowledge that because it's not as, I would say it's not as brutal, it's not as violent, it doesn't look as violent as a knockout punch, but it's just as lethal as a knockout.
And you said talking is always better than using violence. Are you planning on talking with Jake on Saturday?
After the fight, we'll talk to each other. You know, I don't dislike Jake. He's one of the fighters that I admire the most. As a matter of fact, he's one of the guys I wanted to fight for a long time. As a real champion, I want to fight the best guy. And I'm very excited for this fight, you know. I wanted this fight to happen a long time ago. Jake wanted this fight to happen a long time ago. I consider Jake Shield as like a champion. he was like he had like five titles in different organization and different weight class, something that I'd never done before. He have done stuff that I never did, and I want to be the one that stopped Jake Shield. You know, you want to fight me, I want to fight him as well. You know, it's not only him that want me, I wanted to have that fight. Normally when I'm fighting for a title, I'm the champion, so I'm taking the challenger, but challenger want to fight me, I'll take it. But now I have an extra motivation for this fight, you know, which is not trash talk. It's something that most people sometimes don't understand, because, you know, we don't trash talk, we respect each other. But believe me, the Saturday night when the cage will close, it's going to be something different.
Okay, one last question.
George, you say you fight at your best when you're on the edge and when all the pressure's up against you or on you. How do you train and make sure you emulate that and make sure that that best comes out and you are up against the edge?
Well, my training is very simple. You know, if you train in a place where you're the best, yeah, your training is not good. You know, so my trainer, they make sure that when I'm training, I don't always come out on top. Sometimes they have to put me in, they have to figure out a way to put me in a situation that, you know, I'm gonna get beat and I'm gonna have to find a way to survive, or either, you know, sometimes I'm winning, sometimes I'm losing. That's what I mean. And for this fight against Jake Shillan, one of the reasons I'm very excited also is, you know, Jake Shill, it's been a long time I'm gonna fight a guy, and I know Jake Shill is gonna be able to bring the best out of me. You know, the best. I'm gonna have to use some of the weapon that I haven't never used before, you know? So I'm very, very excited for this fight.
Well, thank you everybody for coming today. Thank you, George.